Deuteronomy, the 28th chapter, verse 16 through 68, go in depth about the curses that would befall the children of Israel for disobeying the commandments of God. Those curses did come to pass. We'll begin at verse 52. And he shall besiege thee in all thy gates until thy high and fenced walls come down, wherein thou trustest, throughout all thy land. And he shall besiege thee in all thy gates throughout all thy land, which the Lord thy God hath given thee. And thou shalt eat the fruit of thy own body, the flesh of thy sons and of thy daughters, which the Lord thy God hath given thee in the siege and in the straitness, wherewith thine enemies shall distress thee. This siege was so horrific. This curse was so horrific. It would cause us to eat our own children. As you read from verse 52 down to verse 57, it goes into fathers and mothers eating their own children in order to survive. This same prophecy, this same curse was also mentioned in the New Testament. We'll go to it. Luke chapter 21, verse 20. And when ye shall see Jerusalem compassed with armies, then know that the desolation thereof is nigh. Then let them which are in Judea flee to the mountains, and let them which are in the midst of it depart out, and let not them that are in the countries enter therein. For these be the days of vengeance, that all things which are written may be fulfilled. All things that were written in Deuteronomy, the 20th chapter, which we just read, Leviticus chapter 26, which we shall read, all things must be fulfilled. That siege that we are referring to in Deuteronomy 28, verse 52, that's the siege of Jerusalem. 70 AD, Titus and Vespasian, the Roman armies surrounded Jerusalem and sieged or sacked Jerusalem, putting an end to the Jewish state. I'll continue to read. Verse 23, but woe unto them that are with child, and to them that give suck in those days. For there shall be great distress in the land, and wrath upon this people. When it says woe unto them that are with child, if you remember what we read in Deuteronomy chapter 28, fathers, mothers, friends, foes were going to eat their children. So this is why Jesus the Christ is warning us to flee Jerusalem, because it must be fulfilled what was written in Deuteronomy, the 28th chapter. It was going to be destruction. It was going to be death. It was going to be grief, famine, suffering. So Christ warned us. I'll continue to read. And they shall fall by the edge of the sword, and shall be led away captive into all nations, and Jerusalem shall be trodden down of the Gentiles until the time of the Gentiles be fulfilled. So the sword, meaning death, was going to come, and there would be others occupying that land. Leviticus chapter 26 runs parallel with Deuteronomy, the 28th chapter. I'll start at verse 27. And if ye will not for all this hearken unto me, but walk contrary unto me, then I will walk contrary unto you also in fury. And I, even I, will chastise you seven times for your sins. And ye shall eat the flesh of your sons, and the flesh of your daughters shall ye eat. So here are multiple places that are describing the atrocities that would happen while in the siege. We were going to eat our own young. Now these are the curses that befell the children of Israel, the so-called blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans, that we are the children of Israel. When this siege happened, millions of Jews fled into Africa, fleeing this persecution. It was even documented in the complete works of Flavius Josephus. Many of the rebels during the wars were scattered or sold into slavery. Josephus claimed that 1.1 million people were killed during the siege. 97,000 were captured and enslaved, and many others fled to areas around the Mediterranean. A significant portion of deaths was due to illness and hunger brought about by the Romans, a pestilential destruction upon them, and soon after such a famine as destroyed them more suddenly. So the historical accounts of Flavius Josephus confirms the prophecy that Jesus the Christ gave the children of Israel, which confirmed the prophecies that Moses gave the children of Israel in Deuteronomy chapter 28. Millions of black Jews fled the persecution, fled the siege, and fled into Africa, the interiors thereof. Now this siege went on for a number of years, where no food, no water could enter the city of Jerusalem. It was surrounded by the Roman armies. No one could come out. You were either enslaved or killed. It was desperate times. It was a time of famine, a time of instability mentally and spiritually. But all in all, it had to be fulfilled.